Hi, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now this morning I'm coming to you from Cornville, Maine, and I want to talk about the downsides of having too many apps. Okay, so I don't normally do these on Saturday, but you know, I'm in the States, we'll change things up a little bit. So I told you I was gonna be traveling all day yesterday, and I got to Maine last night at about 2 o'clock in the morning. It was dark, I stayed in a motel, and when I got up this morning, it's really nice out. It's just nice and brisk, and it's a beautiful place. The leaves are red and all that kind of stuff. The big shock to me was the price of the pound. The pound has dropped so much that I changed 65 pounds and got $66. For most of you, that won't mean anything, but if you're in the UK, you might have winced when I said that. It might just be they were screwing me, or it might be, you know, the exchange rate just being really, really bad. But I got a really good question on yesterday's video, and I thought I would address it today just because it was such a nice softball over the plate that I thought I would, you know, let's answer it a little bit. So yesterday, Abby Dabby asked, what do you think about the new AdMob policy on iPhone X devices? Do you know how it can exclude iPhone X on iTunes Connect? I have many apps on the App Store and it really sucks to update them all just because of iPhone X. Now this is, Abby Dabby, this is exactly the same thing I thought. When I got that email saying that the new guidelines came out for iPhone X from AdMob, I just thought, oh God, because I have hundreds of apps and I have to update all of them. And every so often there's like a platform change too. And that's like one of the biggest problems that I have. And if I had some sort of I use Corona SDK, so I don't have like continuous integration in place. I mean, I could, but I just found that so hard to set up, and just the way that I built them before, that it's just a really manual process. And it probably takes me between 20 minutes to do each one, but it's just 20 minutes to an hour, depends if I have to update screenshots or not. And it's just a pain. And this is one of the downsides. In fact, with this whole Apple 4.3 container app thing, that was one of the bright sides I thought about. It was like, well, at least if I had a container app, when I do these updates, it'll be a lot easier. And I'll consolidate all reviews, all that kind of stuff. But of course, the problem is the marketing. The marketing is gonna be the big problem. And that's the reason I'm fighting it, because, you know, combining all apps into one app will be, from a technical point of view, it would be so much easier. It would make my life easier. From a maintenance point of view, it would make my life so much easier. From a marketing point of view, it would be impossible. It would be really hard or impossible. But, you know, I talk about this sometimes. You know, is it better to have lots of apps or just a few apps? If you have an app that hits and really does well, dude, man, go with the fewer apps. You know, it's harder to do lots of apps. But I still think, you know, when it all comes down to it, I want to be more prolific than just a one-hit wonder, if you know what I mean. You know, just taking one big, put everything into one project and put it out there and hope it works. I mean, if I have an app that's just making a small amount of revenue each day, like just like a dollar or even less than a dollar. Let's say if everyone makes like 50 cents a day or 10 cents a day. To me, that means I got to do more of these. I got to start putting more of them out because I'm looking for the cash flow and not, you know, I'm not looking for the I'm not swinging for the fences, and maybe I should be, but yes, Abby Dabby, to answer your questions, yeah, it really sucks. It really sucks to have to go update them all, and that's, you know, it remains to be seen whether or not I'm actually going to do that, and whether or not Apple will even let me do that, but anyway, so that's it. Anyway, so I want to show you guys a little bit of this town, Cornville, Maine. It's really nice. It's brisk. It's, you know, cold. I'm jet lagged, so I got up, you know, extra early, and anyway, that's it for today. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.